Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Tech Gamers World. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can quickly and easily configure your Thrustmaster T.Flight HOTAS One flight stick for use with helicopters in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024. Before we get started here, if you could click that like button and subscribe to Tech Gamers World, I'm always going to have new and exciting content from the world of video games, technology, and flight simulators dropping all the time. So, let's get to it. So this is Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 being played on a Microsoft Xbox Series X. This is my Thrustmaster T.Flight HOTAS One flight stick, which we'll be using for today's demonstration. Now Microsoft Flight Simulator currently works on Microsoft Xbox Series S and X and Microsoft Windows PC, most notably Windows 10 and Windows 11. You need to make sure that Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 is fully downloaded and installed. Flight sticks do not work with cloud gaming, so that is very important. The game must be installed. If you're playing on the PC, make sure you've downloaded the Thrustmaster T.Flight HOTAS One drivers and updated the firmware to the latest general release version. And now what you're going to see here is all the same, regardless of what supported flight stick you use or which system you use, whether it's Xbox or PC. So, first thing you want to do is connect your Thrustmaster T.Flight HOTAS One to your Xbox using the included USB cable. Connect the USB cable to the Xbox to the USB port. When you do, you'll know because the little light here will turn on, and you won't get any prompts. The way to see that it's connected is to go into the Settings and Controls menu. So to do that, you're going to push down on the right analog stick on your controller and navigate over on the top menu to the Settings wheel. Now here is the Settings and General menu. You're going to press RB twice to bring you to the Controls menu. And if you've successfully connected your flight stick, you will see it show up under the devices list. So in this case, the T.Flight HOTAS One. Now, because we are going to be configuring helicopters, we need to change the aircraft to a helicopter. If you're interested in how to do this for a fixed wing aircraft, check out my other video where I show you the exact same thing doing it with a fixed wing aircraft. So first thing we're going to do here is change the aircraft. So we're going to press Y, which brings you into the Change Aircraft submenus. We're going to hit RB to navigate to helicopters. And we're just going to go ahead here and select the Bell Model 407, which is a standard helicopter. Once that's done, you'll notice some things change. Under the controller presets, we no longer see aircraft controls. We see helicopter controls. So the very first thing you need to do is you need to create two profiles. You need to create a controller profile and a flight stick profile. So let's start with the controller. So navigate down to helicopter controls and go ahead here and hit the little settings wheel and hit duplicate. Now it's going to say my new helicopter's profile. We'll name this helicopter Helicopter 01, and then go ahead and hit apply to all aircraft and set as default. Okay. Now, what we need to do next is move up to the T.Flight HOTAS One and then move down to helicopter controls and duplicate that profile. And we'll call this helicopter, we'll say 02 for purposes of this video. This is a friendly name. You can set it whatever you want. Once those two profiles are set, they are the profiles that you want to make your control surface configurations to. You don't want to edit the existing profile, the default profile, because you want to save that in case you ever need to revert. So that's why I suggest you make profiles. So let's go ahead here and start with the controller profile. So you're saying to me, why do I need to worry about a controller profile if I have my flight stick? Well, you're not going to use your flight stick for everything. You're going to use the controller for free look and assign buttons to some of it that you don't use that often. Now, there are a ton of settings available to configure for all the different surfaces. controls, radio, etc. You don't want to pin everything to the flight stick. So I'm going to show you how to pin an action to the controller now, and then you can go through and set the ones that you want. So you've got a ton here. You've got radio, flight control surfaces, lights, instrument and systems, autopilot, brakes, power management, landing gear, tools, multiplayer, ornithopter, communications, liquid drop system, camera, menu, VR, cockpit, player character, and I'm sure there'll be more. For purposes of this example, I'm going to show you, we'll use lights. So, exterior lights. Toggle lights. This is a good one. You can set a button to turn all the lights on and off. So, to set a button, you're going to go ahead and press A on the controller. It's going to say scanning. Now, select your button. I'm going to use D-pad right. Now, it's set. And as you can see it there. Beacon lights off. We'll do the same thing to show you again. Up. And there you go. You've now assigned actions, buttons to those actions. And you want to do that through all here. So another good one to do is autopilot is a good one. Airspeed hold, same thing. We're scanning. D-pad down, left I'll do. Altitude hold, that's another good one. D-pad down. So now I've got altitude, air, autopilot on one side and lights on the other. And again, totally customizable. You can configure every button all you want. Same thing goes for the flight stick. Flight stick's a little different, but the same principle applies. So let's go to T-Flight HOTAS One now. So we've switched. Now as you see the flight stick picture, which has that weird X on it, and you have your helicopter control profile set. So now that you're in here, you can start to configure your Thrustmaster T-Flight HOTAS One. So the first thing you want to check is flight control surfaces. Control trimming surfaces is a good one. Again, there is a ton of settings in here. Some of the defaults are already set. So basic ones, decrease rotor lateral trim increase, decrease rotor longitudinal trim, increase rotor longitudinal trim, rotor trim reset. These buttons are already set to, controls and accesses. So you have your ups, down, lefts, right, rotor spin, make the helicopter moves different ways, all that stuff. And same thing goes for flight control surfaces. Actually, let's go into secondary. You'll see here's stuff you can set. One thing that they do is they do include things for airplanes on here that helicopter won't have, like flaps, stuff like that. So you're going to want to set your specific ones that you want, brakes, spoilers, depending on what kind of helicopter you're flying. Primary control surfaces, just to show you here, there's a ton more. You have to go through and set all of these and define them to the buttons that you want, which is all pretty straightforward. It just takes time and testing. Again, brakes, here's a good one. Parking brake, you can set your parking brake. You can set your brakes here, so when you're moving, you want to set, obviously, the main brakes, not left or right. So let's use an example. Brakes, it's scanning, waiting for input. We use the flight stick previous. So that it's set, and then it's gone ahead and updated the profile for that. You'll do that for all the controls here. So everything, landing gear. If your helicopter has landing gear, you'll see it's set for Y, which is right here on the flight stick. So again, very basic, very easy to do. You just got to go through and take the time to find all the specific ones. Now, let's say that you don't know how to find a specific one. They have this nice search feature. So you go up to search and you can search brakes is a good one. And go ahead and press brakes. Now you'll see that it's searched for everything that has the word brakes in it. So then you can go through and define your settings for brake specific. You can do the same thing for planes, for afterburners, reverse thrust, stuff like that. So once you are done here, you want to go ahead and go back to get out of here, and then you want to press B to save and back. So what that's going to do is it'll exit you back to the main menu, and your flight controls are saved as those profiles. And that's it. That's how you configure a flight stick to work with helicopters in Microsoft Flight Simulator. If anyone has any questions or comments or needs help finding a specific flight control that you're looking for or need a recommendation, drop a comment down below and I will definitely do my best to help you out. I hope everybody likes Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024. I know I'm excited. As always, if you can click that like button and subscribe to Tech Gamers World, that would be totally awesome. We're going to have new and exciting content from the world of video games, flight simulators, and technology dropping all the time. Thanks a lot, everybody, and I will see you around. Keep on flying.